Welcome to another video from the Voyager Middle School STEAM Lab. We're going to do another SOLIDWORKS video. This is a first draft of my SOLIDWORKS video for the cookie cutter. I'm finding that I have to do these videos twice because I usually think of a better way. So we're going to make a cookie cutter like this. My students are going to use a snowman first, trying to get the sizes right, make sure all the thicknesses are right, and then they can try their own design. As usual, I have an outline here. We are going to follow steps A through E, and we are going to figure out how to make this cookie cutter by doing 5 steps. So the first thing we're going to do is sketch the cookie. We're not going to sketch the cookie cutter because the cookie is this empty space in the inside. Then we're going to offset outwards. We're going to offset outwards a thin amount for the cutter part. This is the part that sticks up the most. And then we're going to offset outward again for the handle part that adds extra strength. The cutter wants to be thin enough that it cuts through the cookie dough, but not so thin that it's so thin it's going to break right away. This handle on the outside here, this provides a little bit of strength. So when we're making this design, we're making it the way it's going to be 3D printed with the handle on the bottom. But when we cut it, we're actually going to turn it upside down and cut it like this. So that means if you're doing something with letters in it, you need to reverse the letters in your design. So let's go through this one step at a time. We're going to start with a new part in SOLIDWORKS. I'm going to pick a plane to work on, like the top plane, and I'm going to make sure my view is normal to that. I would start off with the snowman just so that you get a sense of what the snowman is. We're always going to start in sketch for 2D. We're going to draw 3 circles, and I'm going to make sure that my 3 circles are lined up with the centers so that the centers are in a line. I've got my 3 circles. I don't want any lines on the inside, so that's when I'm going to go to trim and just drag across the lines I don't want. This is the new tool that we're using. It's offset entities. So offset is something that you use a lot when you're trying to make a thickness of something. So you can see that there's a blue line that's offset from this black line or vice versa. So you're going to click offset entities. You're going to choose the line that you want to offset from. And then it will say how many millimeters we want to offset. Oh, that didn't work. Let's try that again. I'm sorry. Offset entities. I'm going to choose the lines I want to offset by clicking them. It's going to give me those lines 10 millimeters away. I can also change that number. So I can, let's undo that so we can do that again. We're going to offset entities. Oh, they're all selected that time, so it did it automatically. I can add dimensions, I can reverse, I can select chain. I've got all these different options here. So if I just click check, it actually puts this dimension here. So if I don't want 10 and I want 5 instead, I can just change it like that. So my first measurement needs to be thin. So if you're in my class, you should measure an example cookie cutter and figure out how thin you want this measurement to be. The second one, so 5 is probably not correct. The second one needs to be a little bit bigger. So I'm going to select this ahead of time this time. That's what I learned from the last time. Offset entities, and you can see that one's going to go outside the other line. So now I've got these 3 regions, and these 3 regions can all be extruded separately. I don't want to extrude the inside. I do want to extrude this side. I do want to extrude this side. If I get this inside filled in, I can always use an extruded hole. So I'm going to exit my sketch and go to the features menu and use my extruded boss bases. So when I choose that, it doesn't know what I want to extrude. And if I just start clicking on things, it's going to start filling them in. But that's not actually what I want to extrude. I want to extrude this part. So you can see region 1, not contour 1. So I'm going to click on contour 1 and hit delete. So this is the cutter part. It needs to be tall and thin. So I can drag this arrow to make it taller. And I can click on the check mark to finish my extrusion. So this part only extrudes out a little bit. So I'm going to extrude this part right here. Let's try again. Extrude. Oh, that's right. I forgot. So what's happened is when I extrude this first part, my sketch kind of disappears. It gets rolled up into this. And now it is a parent of that. So if I want to use this sketch to extrude again, I got to pre-select. That will allow me to select things from that sketch. It, by default, it's going to extrude to the same height that I did before, which is not what I want. So you can go down like this. You can type in a number. You can set it to just a little bit. Sorry for the phone call. Let's see what's going to happen when I hit the check mark here. If I click that check mark, I've actually all done. That's all I need to do to make a 3D printed cookie cutter. It doesn't take a whole lot. Watch my other video to figure out how you can make a more interesting shape by using an image and tracing it by hand using the spline tool, or you can actually, there's an auto trace feature that's built into SolidWorks that you can use, so you can get a more interesting outline than this. So have fun making some cookie cutters.